No, just now or five minutes ago?
Oh, okay. As you're coming, because you're gonna pick your hands like this anyway.
How's that feel, good?
So does that mean I'm going too vertical and I'm not going too early?
And you put your hand on your chest.
Yeah, basically what you're doing is you're bridging and then turning over that shoulder.
So the.
You're looking off from that to hat.
Once you get over, you either want.
They're gonna pop it.
It's gonna be a little move to that too. They burst with you.
Look at your hurts for you now.
No, that way I don't have to pull.
Can you do it?
It's 10 to 1.
Oh, okay. So we have.
Alright, well, do you have any questions?
I have to push you down.
Yeah. Do you? Okay, let's go with the board. The worst is going, this is how I can do it.
My neck, yeah, there you go.
My hand.
Now hook your hand over my shoulder more. Yeah, lift your elbow a little bit. See that? It almost hurts me to put weight on you, but you're choking me.
Okay.
That's the idea. You know, choke me. Weight on. Yeah.
Body language.
And then you just get into your side.
I might actually admit that if you do this, I might start trying to step away from you. But if we're here, this is why you drop your dust. Your hands here should be defending your head, so I cover like the lines of my head. It's much harder for you to like penetrate right here.
You can see my pelvis.
I can't just do that. I have to start relaxing. Not enough to do it here.
Awesome.
But the pelvis is not coming from like hugging around you here. You're not turning around. Right. So when we're learning the basics, we're just dealing with one type of aggression first. So this is just a when someone's making that comfortable. I'm not comfortable, my hands are somewhere here. Like if I'm wearing a backpack, they're like here. Okay.
Nice bridge.
Right? Or someone's like, someone comes in here and I'm already on my phone. I keep my hands here. I don't have to do this. My hands are low. You can slap me right now. Right? Yes. Show me your. under the tower. Yeah. So usually when she falls this, so like my wrist is like in that manner, and it can be like, I don't know, I feel like I was just like
taking
my
okay. So once we like go, so we're at the bus. Let's say you wear the switch and you have that, right?
So one thing that happens is when they're being mounted, realistically the person like probably locked up on top of me, and their body weight is like in my center. So we're gonna pretend that like her knees are a little higher and she's a little bit like on my stomach. She's already joking here, right? I might feel a little bit like I'm under pressure now. So I need to start making a frame. So making frames is one of those things you can do that has nothing to do with size or position. So if, for example, she's loaded, we're going to pretend, she's like all the way on top of me right now. I'm going to punch my hand across the waist, and I'm going to make a little room here for me. So I'm driving her hips, they're close to my hips. And when this happens, I can bridge her back. Right? If she's on the bottom, it's hard for me to bridge her back. But if you have hips, then I have all this power and I can generate. It looks like this. And if you're sitting a little upright and you're choking me, I need to start switching. So I need to make sure that I grab it here. I scoot my butt.
Or you have chancy in the later.
And then I'll try to take your foot
out. Something funny.
It's hard. By the time you're doing all of that, I'm using my elbow. You see where my elbow is right now on the side? It's basically underneath her ribcage and by her hip. I'm using all of that. So you have to be connected. So don't just turn your hips without using your whole body. So we're going to try that right now. So when you guys do this, try not to think about them as finding pieces like one, two, three. You're thinking about it as one connected whole. What makes it one connected whole? When I start connecting myself to you, then you have to connect yourself to me.
Boom. Boom.
Tight. Everything's tight.
Leg over head. Let me go ahead now.
Yeah, so try to stay. Yes, stay upright. So it's not going to be simple. You know what I mean? It's going to be difficult with someone much bigger than you. But this is much better connecting already. And this one, even if I'm low, great. Boom. Power. That's a lot of power. Okay?
Yeah.
I almost prefer the person overcommits their body weight. Makes it much easier. If the person's really stiff too, they're like a mummy. It's really easy to move. But if you're like super gangly and heavy, it's much harder to move. So sometimes like the best offense for you as the bottom person, like it's defensive, you're defending from a bottom position. But obviously, you have to think about it more like you want to get to that position before they do. And what you don't want is when the person's on top, since you're on the bottom.
The bigger problem will be very harsh.
What you don't want is the person who's on top.
That's
what you don't want.
It's an
easy squeeze. So you're going to shimmy your shoulders, walk your shoulders. Much better. Now when you bump your hips, we're loading together. Right? If I'm up here and bump your hips, it's not strong enough. You feel all my body is strong.
I lose pressure on the children.
So as soon as we get here, try to adjust it.
I have to stand over.
Very simple. This has two effects. One, I can keep my hand away here, and I can't keep my elbow back. So if you're holding it this strong,
now I sit back, because now is your part.
That's how you need that connection.
control the posture.
Where's that keep going with this?
Control that at first, before you sit back.
There's nothing simple about getting up and doing punches.
Sit up with you.
For me, the first lesson, I had to go through it many, many times. So that I can sit back now. Always remember, this is how you're on the stage.